Blues Room, brought to you by Michelob Light on the Classic Rock Station, 105.9 WCXR.
Hi, this is Merl Saunders from the Rainforest Band. You got the Blues Room on 105.9 WCXR. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Good evening, Merl, and welcome to the Blues Room.
How you doing, Thomas?
You have a brand new CD out with the Rainforest Band called It's in the Air. I know you're excited about it.
Oh, I'm really excited about it. You know, we decided to do a studio version of the band, go to the studio. We went over to Fantasy Records over in Berkeley. I'm quite familiar for the past 15 years. I've been, used to be over there. But anyway, our last album was done live with Dats, you know, and Save the Planet, so we'll have some place to boogie. So we wanted to get this sound from the studio. And I called in some friends, Dr. John, who was coming in from Paris, flew in from Paris. As a matter of fact, he was doing that weekend with B.B. King at the Circle Star Theater. So I called him up and told him, hey, man, I got the song that we need to sing this duet, Paris Blues. And he just started laughing because we've been trying to do something together for the past 20 years, you know. So he came over to the studio, and they had the piano set up. They had the organ set up. And then the engineer said, look, you guys sit down and play the track first, and then go in the booth and sing. And the doctor said, no, man, we're going to do this shit right now, you know, and we're going to do it right now facing one another. We're going to play it right now. And that's what went on the track. And we had so much fun doing it, you know, and that was the first take.
You have quite a history. You've been around in the music business over 30 years playing keyboards and organ. But let's talk now about the inception of the Rainforest Band. We all know about the plight of the Pinon Indians and their apparently, they're not being able to habitate on their land. The government of Malaysia wants to get rid of them and tell them they have no land rights. But what got you involved with the Rainforest Band? Jerry Garcia or what?
Well, I've always been a kind of environmentalist or, you know, environmental-minded 25, 30 years ago. Even before that, you know, it was when going to church and went around to the members and said, hey, can I have your bottles in this? And take the bottles and turn them in. Of course, that was called allowance. It wasn't called recycling, you know. And later in the early 70s, wrote a song about Save Mother Earth. Put out a thing called, the Funky System, things like this. They would not play it, you know. The only place they played it on college stations, you know. And it became very popular. So this time, in the 89, I decided to put out Blues from the Rainforest. There had been a lot of literature of Sting and the Grateful Dead doing concerts in New York, Madison Square Garden. I decided to do something without lyrics and to see if I can get it to the hearts of the people through music and write something like, the Rainforest has the blues, the people have the blues, the land has the blues, Blues from the Rainforest. And wanted to show that hurt feeling and the happiness, what happens in the jungle. It took off because I didn't have no idea it was going to be number four on Billboard charts as number four. And I had called up Garcia and told him what I was doing, and I wanted to give some of the proceeds to the Rainforest Action Network in San Francisco. And he came down, I sent a track up to him, he came down and said, yo, man, he wanted to get involved. And that's how it just took off. Then I said, I have to put a Rainforest Band together. I put one, this is Rainforest Band 3. And it's the most tightest band I've ever had, you know, of all the bands.
Let's talk now about the blues. How did the blues affect your career?
I've always had the blues, you know, from coming up in San Francisco. There's a theater called the Golden Gate Theater. I think my mom and dad took me there at a young age, and I saw some gentleman called Cab Calloway, and I was about 7 years old. And they took me to see Louis Jordan. That was when it hit me that's what I wanted to do, play the blues and be an entertainer on stage, you know. And I've studied classical music, gospel music, but the blues is what I really come from, you know. Those are my roots. And I played for BB at one time, I played for Lionel Hampton for one time, and He even goes down to playing with Miles Davis, Lena Horne. He goes on and on and on. But the blues is what I really do. I always implement putting the blues in there, you know. I love the blues. This is back to my roots. Jessica, my organ, she's so happy to be out there again, you know, because for a while I didn't carry Jessica with me, but the organ is so predominant. People didn't really want to see me standing beside a synthesizer, but I have a synthesizer on Jessica. For a while, Jessica wouldn't even work with the synthesizer on it. She got very upset, you know. So she's very happy by this album because I'm back to playing the blues with Jessica, the way I started in the beginning.
On the brand new CD, you do a Willie Dixon tune that Howlin' Wolf did called Built for Comfort.
Yeah.
Why'd you pick that?
I had a chance. I met Willie Dixon, and he impressed me so much. You know, I worked with the Grammys too, and I was in New York, and I walked up to him. I said, Willie Dixon, you've always been a fan of mine, and he says, my name is Merl Saunders, and he immediately gave me a hug, organ player. And so I said, man, I got to do your song, Built for Comfort. I love that song. About 4 months after that, he passed away. And I said I would do it, put it in my album. And a young man by the name of John Popper is a great harmonica player out of Blues Travelers. I'm in love with the band, and I asked him to play harmonica on it, and he was just tickled to death to do that. So.
You're listening to The Blues Room on 105.9 WCXR. Our guest tonight is Merl Saunders. Merl, will you pick a few blues tunes to play for us? Play DJ tonight? Whatever you want.
Sure. Let's see. Howlin' Wolf. I think I love that. Big Mama Thornton. Big Mama Thornton spent some time in San Francisco. Oh, my goodness. Paul Butterfield. I love that. With Maria Muldaur. It's what is the name of that song right there? Baby?
Baby, Please Don't Go.
Baby, Please Don't Go. Oh, yeah, that's great. I love James Cotton. And The Thrill Is Gone by B.B. King. Great.
Okay. We'll do those and come back and talk.
Great.
Oh, baby, please don't go. Oh, baby, please don't go.
We've been listening to some of the music that Merl Saunders just picked. Paul Butterfield's Better Days with Maria Muldaur doing a Baby Please Don't Go. Now, you did a duet with Maria on one of your Rainforest albums.
Yeah, G Baby Ain't I Good to You at the Great American Music Hall in San Francisco. It was so weird. We had just finished playing this tune. It was, a big rock and roll tune. And all of a sudden, she comes down the aisle. And I went into the intro of G Baby. And she starts smiling because this is the, you know, Better Days. I was also in that group with Paul Butterfield. And we did that particular number together. And I start singing, and she walked up on stage, and that's when I sang, Please Turn the Mic On Over There, you know, and because it was just a spur of the moment. And, you know, she's a professional, and she is great. So that's how that took off right there. You know, I love to do things on the spot, you know.
She has something new out called Louisiana Call.
I haven't heard it. Matter of fact, I've been trying to see her thing, and also her daughter has an album out that I was trying to get.
You got The Blues Room on 105.9 WCXR. Our guest tonight is Merl Saunders, and we're talking about his brand new CD, It's in the Air. You had an association with John Cipollina from Quicksilver.
Yes, sweet man. We had been knowing this man for 25 years. And I had been, actually, people had told me so many wild stories about him that I really didn't. We just, you know, spoke all the time at Winterland High by when, you know, and John was always dressed in black, and you know that look, John. I had a chance to room with him. I went out with Nick Gravanitis' band, and I think it was a Quicksilver band, and somehow there was some friction where. They didn't want John's lady to be on tour with her. So I said, John, the three of us can room together. I said, you got the bedroom, and I'm up early, so I'll sleep on the couch. We had the hell of a time. I really began to know John. He became one of my best buddies. He's a sweet man, and all that BS about him being this and that and that and that. Through that, he's a comedian, really, an outrageous player.
And nobody was left out in the cold.
Right. He loved that tune, Left Out in the Cold. He loved that tune. He made me play it, you know, all the time.
Why don't we fire that up and come back and talk?
Great. Love you, John.
If anyone wants to write for information about helping the environment and the rainforest, what do you suggest they do?
They either contact a Rainforest Action Network in San Francisco or just write Sumertone Records, Post Office Box 22184, and that's San Francisco, California, and the zip is 94122. Or pick up the phone and call Sumertone Records, area code 415-759-8100.
When I was out in San Francisco to stay with Gary Duncan and do a story on them, I went to Blues at Lou's down there at the Wharf. That place has a history to it, doesn't it, as far as, you know, perpetuating blues music?
It certainly does. The Wharfield? Wharfield's where I used to go when I was 8, 9, 10 years. I used to go from the Golden Gate and go to the Wharfield and see all the Bobby Bland, Count Basie. It was just some great blues numbers. Also, they played up on the Fillmore dish. They had one of the ballrooms. I used to stand in the stairway and see Charles Brown with the Blazers. You know, he'd have this white tuxedo on. Yeah, he's great.
He has a duet album out with Bonnie Raitt now.
Oh, right now? Oh, that's great. No, I didn't know that.
Going back to your CD, Save the Planet, So We'll Have Some Place to Boogie, you do Sugar Ray.
Yeah, there was a challenge. Someone in New York, New Yorkers always, you know, put you up to do something. He said, do Sugar Ray. And I said, sure. So I counted it off as a shuffle blues. And it took up, everyone just started laughing. They really liked it. And that's one of the most powerful numbers that we do on our, you know, in our engagement. Last night at Virginia Beach, we blew the fuse, and we were doing Sugar Ray. I don't know if they actually pulled the club. We're very uptight, but they stopped us right at 2 o'clock, and they stopped us. And we were I had the audience singing Sugar Ray, and it blew the club's mind because they kept on singing it over and over and again. So we stayed up in another half an hour on the stage just singing Sugar Ray over and over again. It was very good.
What's ahead for Merl Saunders in 1993?
Well, we're going back, and we've been on the road just about 7 weeks now, and we're going back. I'm going to put another album out, like the Blues for the Rainforest. And it will only be about the Amazon. I spent 15 days on the Amazon River. I saw pink dolphins. I saw a whole lot of incredible things that I have never seen in my life before. And I've wrote a little bit about it when I was over there. I took my instrument over there, and I'm going to come up with some of that. Also, finish a children's album. Actually writing a children's script. I've been on that maybe about 3 or 4 years, and time for us to do Tales of the Crypt. They called us up to come back down to L.A. to do another episode, so we're happy about that. So after that, we hit the road again and go back out there.
Who are some of the keyboard players that influenced you? I mean, guys like Memphis Slim. You mentioned Count Basie.
Charles Brown, Nat King Cole. I loved Pete Johnson, Albert Ammons, Oscar Peterson. I also listened to a lot of horn players like Charlie Parker, Albert Ammons' son, who I had the pleasure of playing with. Matter of fact, he played with me on the first Save Mother Earth, and because I was a young producer and didn't know how to get the track, the leakage away from the drum and the sax, I erased him, and I can kill myself because of that right now. But a lot of influences, like Duke Ellington was Horace Silver, a big influence of mine, and especially organ was that Wild Bill Davis was the first person I saw play organ, and Count Basie. Then the almighty Jimmy Smith was my hero. You know, he helped me really settle down playing organ and sitting, tell me little secrets of the trade, how to groove and move.
You got the Blues Room on 105.9 WCXR. Merl, Pete Sears, and Nick Ravenitis have done the Blues Room over the last few months, and they all rave about you. Nick and I were talking about the soundtrack that you guys put together extemporaneously, Steel Yard Blues.
Oh, that was a beautiful. Me and Maria wrote a wonderful tune for that particular album, and it was great. Nick Gravanitis was one of the pioneers of me doing a lot of work in San Francisco when I came in from New York. It was him. He put me with Bloomfield. He's the one that introduced me to John Kahn from the Bloomfield sessions, and then he says, "I want you to do a session," and he used Garcia. Garcia did. They saw how we clicked, and they began to use Garcia and I on different. I didn't know his name was Garcia. All I knew his name was Jerry, on these different projects. And pretty soon, Jerry said, "Hey man, come down to the Matrix and hang out with me, man. Cause they got an organ down there." I said, "Sure," and that's how that relationship began. You know.
One day I got a phone call from the airport. The guy said, "My name's Jerry." He came up to the station, but he blew my mind when he called me.
Oh yeah. Jerry is a very, very sweet man. Very sweet man. He's a outrageous musician. He's very sensitive. He has that feel for being two or three frames ahead of everybody. Even when we worked together, even in the Saunders Garcia group, the Reconstruction, we would always be ahead of the band. When we'd play, he would take chances which normal musicians wouldn't take, but we'd both be there at the same time. It's like he would go through the door, I would open it for him, you know, and this is vice versa.
Now, you guys did a live recording live at the Keystone with Fogarty and Jerry. Is there any chance that that will be reissued so people can pick up on that?
That is reissued right now in CD. They have the a new one. Matter of fact, Fire Up album has been together with the another album. Our first album was that we collaborated on was Heavy Turbulence. I think that was our first album, which features Save Mother Earth and. I had some background singers by the Hawkins family, Tremaine, Walter, and Edwin. All that's supposed to be reissued. That is reissued now, but I was telling you before, there's some things that at Keystone that has not been touched. There's at least about 10 more songs that people haven't heard. I would like to go back in the vault and battle with Fantasy Records again and get them out, you know. John Fogarty, God bless him, and Tom Fogarty. You know, it never stops. This is one of a hard record company to deal with, you know.
You may have to call in the Blue Ridge Rangers, right?
Yes, please. More than that.
You got the Blues Room at 105.9 WCXR. Our guest tonight is Merl Saunders. Now that we just talked about the Steel Yard Blues, why don't we do Swing With It?
Yeah, that's great. I love that one.
Swing with it, brother. Take it for your own. Swing with it, brother.
Do you have a favorite tune on your brand new CD that you'd like to play?
Well, I like Sister Sadie because it's a Horace Silver tune, and I like Calypso Blues because I first heard that when I was going to high school. There, I first heard Nat King Cole just sing it with a conga player by the name of Jack Costanza. And so I always wanted to put music to it, so we put music to it and kind of put it in the third world. And, you know, San Francisco After Dark is a good favorite of mine. And Resurrection Rag is a great tune. And we put it in this album because it was in the Dinosaur album that got buried because they didn't reissue it or something. But I think they're going to reissue it now, Relics Records. But I went ahead and put it in my album because... Phil DeGare, the producer of Simon & Simon and the Twilight Zone, he wanted me to do a movie for him. And he said the title track, so the name of the movie is going to be Resurrection Rag. And we wrote this music, and I got Hunter to do the words and everything. And pretty soon they said, "Oh, the movie's off." So we had this great tune, and we really like it. We played it, start playing it live, and people just start raving about it. So we just dropped it in the It's in the Air album. So put a new rendition to it and facelift, and it's happening. We like it.
Again, I'd like to thank you and thank Tony Kilbert out there in San Francisco.
Oh, yes, I got to thank him. I also got to say something about my musicians. Michael Hinton on guitar, Michael Warren on bass, and Vince Littleton on drums. I know I call them the most outrageous band I've ever had, you know, and they're a great band, great guys. That is the current lineup. Yeah, it's Vince Littleton on drums, Michael Hinton on guitar, Michael Warren on bass. That is the most dangerous band I've got. And it's not the dangerous band. I think someone else used, Paul Schaefer does that, uses that. I use the most outrageous band.
Anything else you want to say about the Pinon Indians? They're the last nomadic tribe on the earth. They were in the rainforest for, what, 40,000 years, and now they're telling them to get out?
Well, you know, the people have to be educated about this. They have to get into Greenpeace. They have the Rainforest Action Network, Rainforest Alliance. They have to read literature on this because it never hits the paper. And they have to get to hip what's happening so they can get in and talk to their congressmen and their senators so we can make this happen, because this is not democracy in action the way this is happening. And the only way we can make it happening by writing letters to Washington, D.C. and being, let them know how you feel about it. And this is what will clean up this whole mess. This is why I'm out here trying to preach the message and educate the people about what is happening.
Best of luck to you and the Rainforest Band.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for having me. I'll see you next time. I'll bring my keyboards.
Tell Tony to have Carlos Santana call in.
Okay, I certainly will.
Here's Merl Saunders and Jerry Garcia live at the Keystone in the Blues Room on CXR.
They tell me earth will fly up in the sky, waiting for me when I die. From the minute you're born to when you die, you never seem to hear even your cry. And as sure as the sun will shine, gonna get my share. What's my